evening, students. Today we are going to start a new topic, that is data handling. You have in your book in chapter 14. What do you mean by data handling? Let us first try to understand the concept. First of all, we have to understand what is data, and second is how to handle the data. Children, when we are having so many things in our house, okay, suddenly we want to search a particular thing. If we don't arrange those things in a proper place, it is difficult to find, yes or no. Similarly, any information or any topic related to any event, if we are keeping it in a tabular wise, in a proper way, then it is easier to find that thing. Okay, so here we have first whatever data we get that is not organized. So that is called raw data. For example, I have taken here pencil, apple, pen, table, rubber, mango, chair, rose, sharpener, lily, banana, sofa, lotus, bed, grape, sunflower. So these are what? Are these data arranged? They are not arranged. They are unorganized. So we will call this type of data as raw data. Now what we will do? We will like to arrange them. Okay, so we have arranged now, you can see this table, stationery items in one section we have done, for fruits we have done in one section, furniture we have done one section, flowers we have done one section. Now, if together everything would have been kept, just think how it is difficult to find them out, yes or no? Now, when we are arranging it, you will go to that particular section, find your things easily. Yes or no? So that is what we arrange the things. Okay. So we say that the collection of information, facts and figures is called data. And what is data handling? Data handling is the methodical or systematic way of arranging the collected data. So this was our collected data and this is our arranged data. I hope you all have understood the concept now. Now let us learn the different ways of representing data. In this chapter, you are going to learn about these three different ways. One is pictograph, secondly tally remarks and bar graph. In this class, we will only work on these two, first two, that is pictograph and tally marks. Let us see one example here. Here we have the days of the week. Okay. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, I am only taking 4 days, and the number of milk bottles that is sold in each of these days. On Monday, 35 bottles are sold, Tuesday 25, Wednesday 20 and Thursday 30 bottles are sold. Now we want to represent this particular data in pictorial way. Okay, I want to show the pictograph of this particular data. We can see the numbers over here. These all are multiples of 5. So we can draw a particular picture and we can represent it for 5 bottles, one picture for 5 bottles. So I am drawing one picture of milk bottle here, and I am going to represent it for 5 milk bottles. Okay. So this one picture is representing 5 milk bottles. So on Monday we have 35 milk bottles sold. So for 35, how many such bottles you will draw? 35 divided by 5. What is 35 divided by 5? It is 7. So you need to draw 7 milk bottles like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. have 7 milk bottles for Monday. 7 pictures are there, but actually it is 35 milk bottles are sold. Okay, now let us move to Tuesday in the same way. So for Tuesday, the number is 25. 25 divided by 5, how much it is? 5. So we have to draw 5 milk bottles here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we move to Wednesday. Wednesday we have the number of milk bottles 20. So tell me now how many milk bottles I have to draw here, how many pictures I have to draw here. 20 divided by 5, that is 4. So we have to draw 4 here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we move to Thursday. Thursday the number is 30. So 30 means 30 divided by 5 is 6. So 6 bottles we need to draw here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is how we have represented the milk bottles in a picture. This is the picture form of representing. Now, we can also represent this same data through tallymarks. So, let me show you how we can represent the same data through tallymarks. This is instead of pictorial representation, we will do the tallymarks representation. In tallymarks, what are we doing? We are putting lines like this. This type of lines we are putting. So for every collection of 5, we are making one group of 5 lines. Okay, how we are making the group? First you draw 5 lines in this way, and 5th line is just from these two starting and ending corners, you will just make one more line. So this is the way how you represent the tally marks. Okay, so for 35 also we can group it in 5, 5, 5, yes or no? So tell me how many such 5 will come for 35? 7. So make the tally marks for 7 like this. This is 1, this is 2, so it is 10 now. Okay, now this is your 15. This is for Monday. Now let us move towards Tuesday. Tuesday we have the number of milk bottles sold is 25. So in this form 5, 5, we have to make how many? 4. Sorry, 25 it is, so 5. So this is 5 for Tuesday, first 5, then this is the second group of 5. 10 is over, 15 over, 20 over, and 25 over. So Tuesday is over. Now we move to Wednesday. Wednesday it is showing how many? 20. So 5 fours are 20. So 5 10, 15 and 20. Next is Thursday, it is 30. So 5, 6, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and another, this is your 6. So this is the total 30 milk bottles are represented in here. Okay, this is how we are representing the numbers in tally marks. Now let us do one question from Let's Recall. Look at page number 186 and you will find the question from Let's Recall. Read the data about the favorite books of children in a class and represent it using pictograph and tally marks. Then answer the questions that follow. So first we have to represent the data. So this is the data which is given in the book. We have types of books. We have children over here. Okay. And what are the different types of books you see? Adventure, horror, comics, fairy tales, scientific, others. And these are the number of children's. We have to represent this data first through pictograph and then by the tally marks. Okay, let us first do it through pictographs. Okay. We have here types of books and the children. We are representing children through smileys. See, I have taken smileys. You can take any shape. You can take triangle, you can take circles. Okay, as you wish you can take. But I am representing through smileys. Okay, one smiley is representing children. But how many children? It is representing two children. Okay, I have written here through arrow marks. One smiley is representing two children. Okay, if I will take half smiley means it will represent how much? This is half smiley. Okay, this will represent how much? It will represent one child. Okay, this is the information that I have to put inside. Now, types of books. The first type of book is what? It is adventure. Adventure. Under adventure, how many children are there? There are 10 children. And we are representing one smiley for two children. So 10 divided by 2 is how much? 5. So 5 smileys we have to draw there. This is my first one, second, third, four, and this is the last one, 5. Okay, total 5 smileys for 10 children. The next book is your horror. How many children are reading horror books? 5 children. So 4 plus 1 is 5. So I will represent 2 smileys for 4 children and 1 half for 5 children. We'll make 5 children. Okay, so this is the representing 5 children. Now the next book is what? Comics. Comics, how many children it is showing? It is showing 12. Okay. So 12 means total how many smileys you have to make? If one smiley is 2 children, so for 12, it is 6 smileys you have to make. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. last one, that is 6. Total 6 children for 12 comics books. Okay. Sorry, 12 children for comics books. So I have done 6 smileys. Next is fairy tales. How much? 3. Fairy tales. Means you make one smiley representing 2 children, and another will be half. Next is scientific. Scientific, how many children it is showing? It is showing 4. Means we can do it only 2 smileys here to show scientific. Only 2 smileys you can show to represent 4 children for scientific. Next, the last one is others. Others, there are 8 children, so you can make 8 divided by 2, that is 4 smileys. So this completes my pictograph. Now we want to do a tally chart. So tally chart means what? I have already explained, we have to do 4 vertical lines and we have to, like this, 4 vertical lines, and we have to cross it in this way. So this forms, this is representing 5 numbers. Okay, so for adventure, what will you do? How will you represent through tally? Okay, for adventure, how will you represent? It will be 5, 5, 10. So like this, 2 times you have to draw. 1, 2, 3, 4 lines and 1 crossing it. Then 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1 crossing it. So 10 over. Next number is 5. Next is comics. So this is 10 plus 2. Comics over. Now it is 3. Only 3 lines over. Next is scientific. Only 4 lines. And then others, it is 8. First you make 5 and then 3. 5 plus 3 is 8. So this is completes my tally marks. So it is. Okay, now let us solve the questions which was based on the data given before. How many children are there in all? So this is the column for children. Let us count the numbers. What it is? 10 plus 5 plus 12 plus 3 plus 4 plus 8. 10 plus 5 is 15. 15 plus 12 is what? 27. 27 plus 3 is 30. 34 plus 8 is 42. Now, which type of book is most popular? The book that maximum number of children are reading, that is the most popular book. So we find the maximum number of children for comics. So comics is most popular book. Next question, how many children like adventure and scientific books. This is adventure and this is scientific. That is 10 plus 4, 14 students, 14 children. Next question, how many children do not like comics? So out of 42 children, 12 are liking comics. Okay, so rest children are not liking comics. Okay, so we can write 42 minus 12. 42 minus 12, that is equal to 30 children. 30 children do not like comics. Last question, how many children like horror, comics and fairy tales? Horror it is 5. For comics, how much it is? 12. So 5 plus 12. Fairy tales it is 3. So 5 plus 12 plus 3. The number comes to 20. So 20 children, they like horror, comics and fairy tales.